Welcome to Desktop Deployment Essentials, our new series to help you prepare for your shift to Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus. In the next few minutes, we'll explore the next step in our deployment process wheel by reviewing the tools and options for you to migrate user files and settings at scale. Now, this includes common approaches used as part of a task sequence-based automated deployment, manual approaches available to backup and restore files, and a new option using the cloud in OneDrive called Known Folder Move that helps you move your files to the cloud and increase information protection and governance over those files. Now, one of the trickiest and often most manual parts of large-scale deployment is transferring user files and settings to new PCs or backing up and restoring files as part of a PC refresh or reimaging process. First, let's look at your automation options. Task sequence-based deployment automation tools like Config Manager and MDT leverage the User State Migration Tool, or USMT, as part of an end-to-end deployment process. USMT captures user accounts, user files, operating system settings, and application settings, then migrates them to the new Windows installation. You can use the tool for both PC replacement and PC refresh migrations. It can give you the advantage of controlling exactly what gets migrated, and optionally you can exclude unwanted file types like audio and video files or executables. USMT also allows for migration stores to be encrypted to reduce the risk of data being compromised while temporarily being stored on file servers. Also, for PC refresh cases where the primary Windows partition is not formatted, you can use hard link migration with USMT. Now, this process preserves the user state while the old operating system and apps are removed. And because the restore process is actually coming from the same local partition, it significantly improves migration performance and reduces network traffic. Now, everyone is different when it comes to deciding on what to keep when moving to a new PC or a new version of Windows. Some users might want to keep everything, while other users might want to use this opportunity to clean up their drives. Because of this, a lot of IT departments actually handle user file migration manually. Sometimes this is done by visiting the user, and other times by setting up places for users to bring their PCs to IT. Now, that way, users can also help decide what to keep. Now, the scale of manual migration is obviously limited to the time and physics involved in working directly with those users to understand their needs, copy files off their PCs, and return them back to the new PC or new install of Windows. If this manual process is what you're currently doing, you might want to calculate whether this is going to be a potential bottleneck in terms of meeting that January 2020 end of support timeline for Windows 7, and look into maybe other options or requests for more people to help. Next, while both the automated and manual methods that I just described are commonly used, one new option with OneDrive called Node Folder Move is a great way for you to align both IT and user needs, reducing the need for manual migration. Now, if you're already using OneDrive, you'll know that users can select the folders and locations they'd like to sync from OneDrive or SharePoint to their device. And of course, they can move the files they want into OneDrive into those synced locations on their PC. But that effectively puts the burden on the end user to set it all up. But now with Known Folder Move, you can actually target documents, desktop, and pictures folders within a user profile. And this can be done either as the user, or even more importantly, as a system administrator, you can enforce group policy settings and determine whether file sync happens silently in the background or if it's visible to end users. The nice thing here is that users don't need to change their workflow before, during, or after the file sync. Then after the user takes delivery of that new PC or refreshed PC, these files are available on the device or future devices once the user signs into their OneDrive account. They can even reach their files securely from a phone or another device. OneDrive compared to local network-based file migration options provides additional flexibility using the cloud to synchronize user files and enable secure access on new or refreshed PCs as part of the hardware refresh cycle. Note that in all cases, authentication is powered by Azure AD, so you can also easily enable multi-factor authentication as part of the process. And to optimize for network bandwidth in a large-scale deployment, you can use policies to control the amount of bandwidth used for both upload and download processes. You can also phase the rollout of Known Folder Move using group policy settings for additional control or limit file sync to domain joined PCs if you prefer. Now remember, OneDrive is designed to sync and protect files and folders, but does not sync applications or Windows settings. So those are the options to migrate user files and settings between PCs. But in many cases, you'll also want to configure standard layouts and settings on your managed PCs. In fact, many of you will want to personalize Windows 10 start and taskbar settings, like what's default pinned in the taskbar, and what users see in their start menu. In Windows 10, you won't be using the copy profile method you might be using now. In Windows 10 Pro, Enterprise, and Education, you can use group policy, MDM, PowerShell, or provisioning packages to deploy a customized start and taskbar layout. No reimaging in this case is required, and the layout can be updated simply by overwriting an XML file that contains the layout. Windows 10 also includes many first-party apps as part of the standard installation. In some cases, you might want to remove those apps, for example, things like Xbox or Zune Music, from managed PCs and configure your installation also to prevent those apps from returning back. You can remove unwanted apps either from a running copy of Windows using PowerShell or an offline Windows image using DSM commands. So that was a quick run-through of your options for migrating user files and settings as part of your desktop deployment. Next up on the deployment process wheel, we'll cover your considerations for security and compliance controls as you shift to Windows 10 and Office 365 Pro Plus, along with the things to keep in mind if you're coming from Windows 7. And to learn more about what we covered today, visit the Modern Desktop Deployment Center and keep following our Desktop Deployment Essentials series here on Microsoft Mechanics. Thanks for watching.